ஆண்டவர் ரிசோர்ஸ் பர்சன் டாக்டர் குணபாலன். இட்ஸ் மை பிரிவிலேஜ் டு இன்ட்ரடியூஸ் டாக்டர் ஆர் குணபாலன். டாக்டர் ஆர் குணபாலன் கம்ப்ளீட்டட் இஸ் பிஇ இன் த இயர் ஆஃப் 2000 இன் த ஃபீல்ட் ஆஃப் எலக்ட்ரிக்கல் அண்ட் எலக்ட்ரானிக்ஸ் இன்ஜினியரிங் இன் அண்ணா யூனிவர்சிட்டி. ஆல்சோ கம்ப்ளீட்டட் ஹிஸ் எம்டெக் டிகிரி இன் த ஃபீல்ட் ஆஃப் எலக்ட்ரிக்கல் டிரைவ்ஸ் அண்ட் கண்ட்ரோல் ஃப்ரம் புதுச்சேரி யூனிவர்சிட்டி இன் த இயர் ஆஃப் 2006. ஹி ஆல்சோ கம்ப்ளீட்டட் ஹிஸ் பிஹெச்டி இன் த இயர் of 2015 in electrical engineering from Anna University, Chennai. He is having 17 years of experience in the field of teaching in various institutions. Currently, he is working as an associate professor in School of Electrical Engineering in Vellore Institute of Technology, Chennai. He published 21 international journals, including IEEE Transaction on Power Electronics. He also published and presented 16 international conferences and 19 national level conferences. He also a reviewer in IEEE Transaction journals of IEEE Transaction on Electronics and Industrial Electronics. He also served as a editor for a Turkish journal of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science for a paper titled An Optimal Algorithm for Multi-Level Inverters. He also served as a programmable technical committee member for an international conference which was held at Wuhan, China in the year of 2016. His area of research are sensorless vector control for induction motor and sensorless vector algorithm for speed and flux estimation, LabVIEW-based driver applications. Currently, 5 PhD scholars are doing their research work under his guidance. He is having a lifetime membership in ISTE and is also a member of IEEE and IEI. I humbly request all the participants to take him as a role model and gain knowledge from him. Now, I hand over the session to Gunabalan.
Thank you, Regan, for your nice introduction about my academic details and personal information. Now I start my presentation. I'll share my screen now. I hope the presentation is visible. Is it okay? Organizer, whether the screen is visible or not?
Sir.
Visible.
It's visible, sir. Visible. It's okay.
Good morning, all. So I'm going to deliver a talk on converter topology for LED lighting applications. So you know that in the present scenario, in most of the lighting applications, we are using LED. That is, we are replacing the incandescent, fluorescent, and CFL lamp by LED lamps. So in this lecture, we are going to just give an introduction about the general performance of an LED and what are the different power electronic converter circuits employed to act as a driver for LED. See, the overall presentation outline is given here. So what are the different existing lighting system and what are the merits of LED, then LED characteristics, what are the different converters that are used to drive the LED, then a simple PWM converter is explained in detail with some experimental and simulation result, then what are the different industry in which the LED lamps are manufacturing, then a short conclusion. So the existing lighting system, when you know that, we are using at present incandescent, fluorescent, sodium, mercury, and some energy efficient CFL lamps. So incandescent, fluorescent, and energy efficient lamps are normally used in houses and street lighting applications. And sodium vapor lamp and mercury vapor lamps are used in street lighting and indoor and outdoor applications we are using. When you consider the home appliances or home applications, the lighting is concerned, the electrical energy burn around 25% of the average home energy budget because we are using an incandescent, fluorescent, and energy efficient CFL lamps. So the compared to the energy efficiency of a lamp, the incandescent and the fluorescent lamp power ratings are somewhat high. That will be normally coming under the fluorescent lamp around 40 watts ranges, and incandescent lamp that is available in different power ranges. So what are the demerits of the existing lighting system? So we are using different lighting system, that is incandescent, fluorescent, and other discharge lamps. Generally, demerits are concerned poor color rendering index. What it is, when you see that image or an object in a particular under a particular light, that may be incandescent or a fluorescent or a sodium vapor lamp, the object color is different from the natural color. That is, when you see an object in a natural lighting system compared with that, if there is a change in the differences there, that is actually coming under the color rendering index. So the conventional lighting systems are concerned, that is poor. Then another thing, when you are using a sodium and mercury, that once the lifetime is over, the disposal has some problem because it has some sodium gases as well as the mercury gases. If it is disposed or if it is mixed with the waters or in the surfaces, then it causes some pollution. Then discharge lamps generally have some warm-up time is required to start the lamp. Then due to high power rating, the electricity bill that also increases. Then another thing, the efficiency of this lamp is also very, very minimum due to the poor power factor. So what is actually an LED lamp? Generally we use LED lamp as an indicator in the laboratory in the output side, some 10 milliampere LED rating within series connection of some 330 ohm resistor. That is generally used for indication purposes. But present days, the LED is also used for lighting system with some power ratings of some 1 watt. That means we have to connect the LED depends upon the power requirement, series or a parallel combination. So generally these LEDs are small, very efficient solid bulbs. So the given figure represents an 1 watt LED that is actually a surface mounted type. So now the semiconductor, due to the development of the semiconductor technology, the LED lamps are available in market. Previously, the LED lamp cost was very high, but now due to the development of the semiconductor technology and a number of industry they are manufacturing the semiconductor, that is the LED lamps, the cost of the LED bulb is also gradually decreases. Then the LED bulbs are normally available with some minimum power ranges, some 6 watt, 9 watts, 12 watts, 15, or street tile applications are concerned, some 50 watts or 60 watt power ratings are also available. These are the different LED lamps that is available in the market, that is a diffused lamp. This is similar to the ordinary incandescent lamp type, so we can fix it to the lamp holder. Then another thing is available, that is a dimmable globe LED bulbs. So these bulbs, we can adjust the illumination, that is the brightness control is possible in this lamp is concerned. We can vary the brightness from 10% to 90% of the brightness. Then another thing, that is the LED tube lights are also available with a power rating around some 15 watts ranges. So these power ranges are more or less equivalent to an 40 watts normal fluorescent lamp lighting. So these are the different type of LED lamps that is available in the market. Then what are the merits of generally what the LED lighting? So LED bulbs, when you see that the lifetime of an LED lamps are normally very high. It is coming under around some 50,000 hours. Then there is no mercury or any gases are involved. Then the durability, that is a lifetime of an AP, that is LED, when you take it as that is very high. And the outer frame of the LED, when you see, that is the covering part of the LED, that is generally made up of some plastic material, so it is not damaged quickly. Then generally incandescent lamp or fluorescent lamp, they emit heat energy, but LED lamps are concerned that is very cool in nature. The heat energy that is dissipated from the LED lamps are generally very, very minimum. Then another thing, good color rendering index. that is the any object we can see the nature of that color that is similar to the color when the object is subjected to the natural lighting. Then quick turn on and turn off characteristics. There is no warm up time is required. Then another thing, there is no high striking voltage. When you take it as a fluorescent lamp, it requires a high striking voltage. Then sodium vapor lamp and mercury lamps are concerned, it also requires some high voltages. But LED is concerned, the voltage requirement is also very very minimum. This is similar to the semiconductor concept. So the requirement of the voltage is also a minimum. Then the power consumption, around 6 watts or 9 watts bulb power ratings is also equivalent to the CFL, some around 15 or 16 watts CFL bulb rating we can get it. So the same brightness, the power rating of the LED is generally very very less. In market, the different high brightness LED that is available. So the general current rating of the LEDs varies from 100 milliamperes to 2 amps. The typical current rating of that LED is 350 milliampere current rating. Then standard, the knee voltage or the cut-in voltage of an LED 3 to 4 volt. That means starts conducting from the 3 volt to some 3.5 or 4 volt ranges. Then connected in series and parallel combination, because we can't use a single LED for lighting applications. So depends upon the voltage and the current requirement, the LEDs are connected in series and the parallel combinations. So in the present market, the LED voltages are available from the 12 volt to 140 volt ranges. The LED lamps are available. Low voltages for that is homes and there is some street lighting application. A high voltage, that is 140 volt and all, that will be coming under indoor, some outdoor applications. Then the output current rating of an LED, when you take it as it is from that is 5 ampere to 350 ampere rating, in the sense low voltages with the high current we can operate, or high voltages low current also we can operate. Everything depends upon the power requirement and the voltage that is available. That is the converter, depends upon the converter type. We have to fix the voltage rating and the current rating according to the converter that is available. We can choose the LED, or another way, depends upon the brightness and the power rating of the LED that is available. We have to choose the power electronic converters. Generally, the LED characteristics is concerned. So the characteristics of an LED, generally it is similar to the diode characteristics. That is under the LED to be used under forward bias condition, like a diode. Then the minimum cut-in range of an LED is generally comes under around 2.5 or 2.8 or 3 volt. That is normal voltage of an LED if it is a 4 volt or a 5 volt LED. So once it crosses the cut-in voltages, the LED starts conducting. So below that ranges, when you see that the forward conditions, only a minimum that current flows, that is a forward leakage current that flows under this region. Once it crosses the cut-in point of this, then the current starts increasing. Then another thing, when you see the characteristics not coming under linear, it is a non-linear, or we can say that the forward current increases in an exponential form. Just when you see here, the current voltages increases from 3.03 or around 3 volt to some 3.4 or 3. This is actually 3.6. So around 3 to 3.5 volt ranges, there is an increase in current ranges. It is coming under from 50 milliamperes to around 500 milliampere ranges. That means there is a slight variation of the voltage causes a major change in the current. Then to maintain the brightness of an LED, the current to be maintained as constant. So how this can be possible? That can be possible with the help of employing the power electronic converter, that is generally called as the driver circuits. And another thing, we know that LED is generally operated with the DC current. Then when you are using an LED along with any power electronic converter to simulate an LED, the simple the equivalent circuit or the model of an LED is represented. Generally, LED is represented by an resistor in series with an voltage. That is the drop across the diode that is represented as like a diode. When you take it as a silicon or a germanium diode, we generally represent as a 0.7 volt or a 0.5 volt as a cut-in voltage. Once the voltage crosses that particular level, the device starts conducting. Like that in an LED, suppose when you take a 3 volt LED, once the voltage crosses and above 2.5 volt, the LED starts conducting. That means the brightness of an LED gradually increases. So there is increase in voltage causes the increase in the current that increases the brightness of an LED. So it can be represented by a simple equivalent circuit, that is the voltage and series with the resistance. So this resistance we have to determine and we have to put it in the simulation circuit. Assume that the current rating of an LED is 300 milliamperes. And the voltage across the LED, assume that it is a 3.3 volt and the supply voltage is 5 min, then we can easily calculate what is the resistance of this. That is a given voltage is given as a 5 volt and E is given as a 3.3 and the current rating is given. From this we can calculate what is the internal resistance of that LED. Generally this resistance we will call it as an equivalent series resistance. So the device has generally very low value of the equivalent series resistance, that will generally called as an ESR. So when you are using an LED in any simulation circuit, we can represent the LED equivalent to its equivalent circuit like a resistor in series with the voltage source. That voltage source represents the drop across the LED. If you are connecting multiple LEDs in series, in such a cases we have to account all the voltages, because when you are connecting in series the current remains same. Multiple LEDs in series, each LED voltage is to be added, then finally you have to calculate what is the value of the resistance. In some simulation tool example, when you take it as a PSim and all, the LED is directly available, then we can directly use it in the simulation file. Then when you compare the brightness of an LED with respect to the other CFL and incandescent lamp, so here the brightness or the lumen is represented in terms of the lumens. So that gives the amount of light energy that is emitted by the light source, that is generally measured in terms of the lumens, that is the luminous flux is represented in terms of the unit lumens. So when you see 6 and 7 watts of an LED for a 400 to 500 watt lumens or a brightness, it gives a same amount of the brightness for a CFL of 8 to 12 watts or an incandescent lamp of 740 watts. So for a 40 watts incandescent lamp can be replaced by an LED of 6 to 7 watts power ranges. This actually the details is available in a particular manufacturer, that is a verybright.com. So different manufacturer, they have a different power ranges in their side. So we can see and you can go through it, the brightness comparison with respect to LED, CFL and the incandescent. That is, for a same brightness, what is the power rating requirement of an LED, CFL and the incandescent? So generally the power requirement of an LED is, that is the very very minimum. That shows that for a same brightness, when you are using an LED lamp, the power consumption is also a minimum, that automatically reduces the electricity bill. So now we have gone through the what is the purpose of an LED, what are the different type of lighting sources available, then what is the merits of an LED, what is the characteristics of an LED, now how we have to represent the LED in equivalent circuit. Now to operate the LED in the constant current mode, we need different power electronics converters, because the available source in the from the EB in home or any applications or industry or any companies, that is normally available supply is an AC, but the LED is operated by the DC current, and so DC sources are required. So for the AC to DC conversion, we need different power electronics converters. So AC to DC conversion, we know that we can use the diode rectifier, but when you are using a diode rectifier, the output voltage level is fixed. But LEDs are available with the low voltage ranges with low power rating. So we have to convert that DC into a minimum DC voltage requirement. So for that, we need a different DC to DC converter topologies. So generally, the converters are classified into two different categories. One is topologies without isolation. Second one is topologies with isolation. So the topologies without isolation, that is classified again passive topology and active topology. Passive topology means there is no power electronic switches are employed, only diodes, then some resistor and the capacitors. So such a circuit, that means only the passive elements are used in the circuit. Then active topology, in the active topology only the power electronic semiconductor devices are used, either a MOSFET or an IGBT, depends upon the voltage and the current rating, or depends upon the switching frequency. We can choose either a MOSFET or an IGBT. Then again, the active topology, that is again classified into a single stage and a two stage. Then these topologies are coming under either without isolation or with isolation. What is without isolation? You know that the input supply is connected to the converter, then the converter to the, if it may be another converter with an LED, or we can use to limit the voltage level. We can connect a series resistor, so automatically there is a reduction in the voltage level. Then we can use a rectifier. Such a way also we can use it. So there is no isolation in between. If, so second case is topology with isolation, mean in between the supply and to the LED, that is to the final circuit, there may be any isolation transformer if you are using. So such a topology, that is coming under the topology with isolation. The best example for this is actually the flyback converter. Generally, all the active topologies are coming under this category, because passive topologies are concerned, there is no isolation. Directly, that will be connector to the LED driver circuit with some diode and capacitor, in addition to the some limiting resistors. So the simple introduction about these topologies are given in the further slides. Then finally, we will directly move into some certain type of converters. So this is actually a simple passive topology. That means here actually you represented only the DC source. So in between, in the initial stages, if these LED driver and the LED, if it is directly connected to the line side, then such a cases we need a rectifier also. So the DC source with the current limiting resistors are used to limit the current. So under such a condition, if there is a fluctuation in the voltage level, there is this also causes a fluctuation in the current. So the output current is unregulated. Generally, this we can use it only for a low power applications. Generally, when you see in houses, the present days, they are using different decoration lighting system they are using in a particular room is concerned. So different LED lighting they are using. So these LEDs are normally coming under the low power LEDs. So there we will use some limiting resistor. In addition to this, a small that is some passive circuits only we will use it. Then when you move into the active topologies, so here in the passive topology, only one type of circuit is given, but in addition to this, here different type of passive topologies are there, a value fill circuit, like what are the different circuit we have used in the semiconductor circuits, what you have studied, such as circuits we can use it with some diodes and the capacitor combination. Then active topology, the active topology, it may be of linear regulator type or maybe of a switching regulator type. So in both the cases, we use the power electronic semiconductor devices are used. In the switching regulator, again, a buck converter or maybe boost converter or a buck boost or any type of converters, generally, we can use it as an LED driver. That is, what are the converter topology we studied in power electronics? Such a converter topology, we can use it in the LED driver. Okay, then the converter may be either a one stage or a two stage. Simple example, when you take the second, that is the first circuit is actually the linear regulator and second one is a switching regulator. So from the DC to DC, we are using another DC to DC converter. In the passive topology, there may be one limiting resistors we can employ to limit the current, or in addition, if you want, we can connect a limiting resistor in series also. So here only one stage of conversion is there, that is generally called as a single stage. In some converters we will use a multiple converters also, that is two more stages are also there, that is we can see it later. So this gives an idea about the single stage converter, that is an AC supply that is converted into a DC, then we are using a filter, then using a DC to DC converter, we are giving the required voltage and current to the LED. So here the LEDs are connected either in series or a parallel combination. So generally when you see the drawback of these converters are concerned, the line voltage is purely sinusoidal, and when you seek the line current, that has some that is a harmonic content. Okay, so if such a conditions are there, the power factor will be coming under very poor. So to increase the power factor of this converter, that means to increase the line side power factor, we have to connect additional stages that is actually coming under this two stage converters. So in the two stage converter, a rectifier, DC DC, and one more DC DC is there. That is, one DC converter is used to regulate the current and voltage of the LED, and one more converter that is required to increase the power factor of the source side. So here, when you are using a transformer with the flyback concept, then that is generally called as an isolation. With isolation or without isolation, we can design the converters. So if it is a two stage, generally one converter to regulate the output voltage and current to the LED, and one converter to improve the power factor in the source side. Then another thing. Instead of a two stage, we can combine these two stages together, and we can use it as again a single stage. Such a type of converter is also available in the market. So next we will move into so we have discussed generally what are the different type of converter topology we can use it, either as a passive topology or as an active topology. In the active topology, again it may be a single stage or it may be of three stage is also available in some of the literature, but generally preferred topologies are two stage and the single stage. So we know that when you see this converter, it is similar to your conventional rectifier type. But in the conventional rectifier, we use only the four diodes. But here, in addition to the four diodes, we have connected some more devices. That is, controlled devices are also connected. That is, IGBTs are connected in the input side. So these switches output is controlled with the help of an pulse width modulation technique. And the output side, we are employing as normal. We are using an inductor and the capacitor to filter the ripple or the noise content, and the input side also we are using an LC filter. Now when you see here, we are using a PWM technique here. There is only one stage of conversion is there. There is no voltage control at the LED separately, and there is no power factor control in the input side separately. With the help of a single converter itself, we can control the power factor as well as we can control the load output voltage and the current. Both can be controlled here in this converter. So let us see what is the operation of this converter. So when you see here, any devices presently that is available in market have an anti-parallel diode. That we know it, because generally we are using an anti-parallel diode inverter or MOSFET is for reason is, one thing is to protect the switches under reverse bias conditions, that reverse voltage condition. Second thing is, if the load is an RLE or an RL load, such a cases the energy present in the load can be fed back to the supply with the help of this and anti-parallel diodes. Generally these diodes, when you are using it in inverter, we will call it as an feedback diodes. Okay, so such a inverter switches are, such a IGBT or the MOSFET switches are used here. So sometime if the switches are blocked, there is a possibility this diode may conduct, and there is a possibility to enter the current into the source. So to block that only, we are connecting a diode in this circuit. So instead of using only four switches, additional four diodes are connected. These four diodes are used to block the reverse current flow to the source side. So such a purpose we are using this. So the general circuit operation is divided into here two different modes. One is in mode one. Mode ones are concerned, we will operate the two different switches, one from the upper leg and another one from the lower leg. So when you see here, mode one, we can operate this switch, that is T1 and T2. So these two switches we can operate. So the current direction from the source to the switches, then to the load, to the switch two, and to the input side. So when you now, as these diodes are connected in the reverse bias condition, these diodes are in open condition. That is the anti-parallel diode to connected in parallel with the switches are in open condition. Okay, so mode one operation. In mode two, the remaining two switches, they are present in the leg, that is T3 and T4 conducting. But here, these switches are not operated continuously. These switches will be operated with the help of an PWM technique. So these switches will be operated on and off in between. So meanwhile, the current to the load is controlled with the help of this inductor present in the circuit. So this inductor maintains a continuous current to the load with the help of this freewheeling diode. Okay, so the main purpose of this converter, that is the switches, is to control the output voltage. A simple example, suppose we are connecting this LED driver directly plug into the main supply voltages. So we are giving a 230 volt directly. Okay, so when you are using a diode rectifier directly, a 230 volt input AC RMS supply is there, mean it gives a maximum of around 320 or 340 volt peak value. When you are using a capacitive filter, again the range is coming at around 320-240. Such a voltage we can't connect to an LED circuit or LED lamp directly. Okay, so here, when you are using a PWM scheme or a controlled switches, such a condition, by varying the pulse width, we can vary the output voltage. So depends upon the voltage range of rating of the lamp that is connected at the output side, the width of the pulse can be varied. So it depends upon the width of the pulses depends upon the voltage rating of this LED, the pulse width is adjusted. So suppose we are using for a street light application with the high voltages, such a conditions also we can use this driver, that means this PWM converter we can use it. If you want to use it for a low voltage applications, if you are reducing the width of the pulses, we can use it for a low voltage applications also. Then if you want to use it for a high current applications, then we can connect the LEDs in a parallel combination, so we can increase the brightness. So we can use it from a low wattage to some high wattage, that is from around 9-10 watts to we can use it from 50-60 watts also. That is from a pathway street lighting applications, we can use this circuit. So the entire circuit is actually constructed in an PSIM, and here that depends upon the voltage requirement. We have generated the switching pulses for the two different switches. So switch 1 and switch 2, actually the switch 1 in the upper leg and another one is in the lower leg. Likewise, switch 3 and switch 4. So the pulse, difference or the time duration between the two pulses when you take it is exactly the 180 degree phase angle difference. But here, the width of the pulse is very, very minimum because the load connected or the LED that is connected at the output voltage has a minimum voltage range. If we are increasing the pulse width, we can increase the voltage range. Such a cases, we can connect a higher voltage range LEDs. That means we have to connect more number of LEDs in series. Simple example, when you are taking a 3-volt LED, the output voltage is only 24 volt. Then such a condition, we can connect 6 LEDs. So 6 into 3, 24 volt. Suppose if we want to increase the pulse width, or you are connecting some instead of 24, some 36, or have more voltage ranges, such a condition we have to increase the LEDs in series according to the voltage ranges, the width of the pulse to be adjusted. Okay, so in this the design circuit, we have designed an LED driver circuit for a 60 volt LED with a current rating of around 0.3 amps, that is a 300 milliampere current rating with a 60 volt LED. We have designed this circuit. So for the 60 volt voltage requirement, the pulse width is adjusted here. So this pulse width is actually around some 60 degree interval, and the switching frequency of this circuit is around 20 kilohertz. So the details are given in the before the experimental result. So now when you see the input voltage and the input current, input voltage, that is a pure sinusoidal. When you see the shape of the current is also, now in the input current, the harmonics present in the input current is actually very, very minimum. Okay, because of the PWM control techniques, we are minimizing the harmonics present in the input side. So when the harmonics are minimized, automatically with the input power factor will increase. When the power factor is increased, automatically the current drawn from the supply that decreases. When current drawn from the supply decreases, automatically the circuit efficiency or the converter efficiency that will increase. So a simple PWM converter, instead of 4 diodes, we have used 4 switching devices. There is no additional converters employed in the circuit. Okay, so when you see the power factor of this circuit, it is coming under this into e power, that means 0.929. And the THT, when you take it as the current THT, that will be coming under around that is 13.57. That is 0.13. If you take this, then it will be in terms of percentage, it will be 13.57. But voltage ripple, that is negligible because voltage is already a sinusoidal signal. So in this converter, the power factor is improved. At the same time, the harmonic content, that is harmonic content present in the input supply also decreased. Okay, so this is the specifications of the converters for used for the real time application. So we have taken a 230 volt direct input voltage, it is connected, and with a switching frequency of 20 kilohertz. Then we have used a power rating of 18 watts with the LED of 60 volt and the 0.3 ampere current rating. So with the 10 that is we have connected a 3 volt LEDs. So for a 60 volt we have connected around 20 LEDs. Then input filter and the output filter, we have used an inductor and the capacitor, so the ratings are given. Then we have used a freewheeling diode at the output side. In addition to this, we have connected input side also, we have connected 4 diodes. So now the diodes are operated with a high switching frequency. So here we have used a fast recovery diodes. We have not used any ordinary diodes what we are using in electronic circuits laboratory. So we have used a fast recovery diode because the switching frequency is very high, so the turn on and turn off time of that diodes also should be high. The turn on and turn off them, that switches to be on and off quickly. Then we have used an IGBT with the 40 ampere current rating, 1200 volt. But here we are using a low power ratings. So instead of an IGBT, we can use the MOSFET also. Then gate driver, we have used here a TLP250, but we may use IR2110 or any other driver's circuits. Whatever the driver circuit we know or we have already designed, such a driver circuit, we can use it. Because the pulse generation circuit generally given pulse output of maximum of 5 volt. If you are using any Arduino or a microcontroller or a DSP processor, the output voltage is 5 volt. Such a 5 voltage is not enough to drive the power semiconductor devices, power electronic devices. So the signal level to be amplified. Such a condition, we generally use a driver circuit. So we can use any type of driver. So this gives an idea about the component, that means the experimental setup of it. So here we have used an auto transformer to adjust the input voltages. So this gives the 4 different that is switches, the main power switches. Then we have connected an input filter and the output filter. Then this represents actually the driver circuit. So we have tested with a different type of driver, but TLP250 only. Then we have designed different inductors we have tested. Because as per the design, using the design equation, we have designed an inductor. Then we have tested the performance at a different inductance value. What is the performance of an inductor? Then the control signal or the switching pulses are generated with the help of the PIC micro controller. So the generator signal that is amplified or the signal level is increased with the help of a TLP driver circuit. So this transformer actually gives the required power supply to the driver circuit, because the TLP driver is also required more than 10 volt input DC supply. So for that purpose, we have used a multi-tapping transformers. In single transformer itself, we have used a multi-tapping, because we have to provide a proper isolation between the pulses for each switches. So instead of using a different transformer, we have taken a single transformer with a multi output. Okay, so this is the power circuit, and the LED we have connected here that represents. Actually, this LED is the street light LED in our campus. So the driver was failed. So we have replaced the driver and we have tested our driver circuit to eliminate this LED. Then to measure the current and voltages, here we have used the LabVIEW devices, that is a voltage sensor and the current sensors are used. In addition to this, we have measured the current and voltages in the that is a MSO also. So this gives an idea about the simple the gate driver TLP258 driver circuit. So we are the gate pulses that is generated from the microcontroller or a DSP processor that is given to the input of the TLP 2 and 3 pins through a current limiting resistor. We can connect either a 220 or a 330 ohm resistor. The pin diagram is given in detail here. And then the output side, again, to limit the current, we have to connect some limiting resistor. And then the supply given to the pin terminal 8 is you can give the supply from 15 to 20 volt. So this voltage range again depends upon the temperature. Suppose if the device is a higher temperature, then you have to reduce or increase the voltage ranges. Then a bypass capacitor is also connected between the ground and the pin number 8. So using this circuit, we can build your own driver circuit. If you have a TLP250 IC, it is a TLP250 is actually an optocoupler IC because it provides an isolation between the gate pulse generation circuit and the main circuit, because these two terminals are connected to the main power circuit. If any fault occurs in the power circuit, you should not affect the driver. So when you see here, if there isn't any fault occurs here, we have an optocoupler isolation is there, so that protects the driver as well as the processor or the microcontroller. So either we can use PIC microcontroller or we can use any DSP processor. But in our laboratory, in addition to this, we have one more tool that is available, that is a DSpace workstation that is also available. So using that also, we can generate the pulses for the any converter, any type of converter, that is a DC to DC converter or a inverter, three phase, single phase, whatever may be the converter, we can generate the pulses very easily. Whatever the model we are building that in the MATLAB, so the MATLAB converter circuits, that means we can generate a pulse using a MATLAB blocks in addition to the block set that is available in the D space. Then another thing is any closed loop control, if you want to perform such a closed loop controller, everything is built in the MATLAB along with the D space controller, and then we can perform the closed loop operation very simple way. So this actually represents the D space panel and the expansion box and the computer system and everything. So the driver circuit is must for any converter. We have to use a driver circuit. So we built a driver circuit for a three phase inverter. So same that is a DSpace platform, we can use it to generate a pulse for a LED driver also. Generally, the LED drivers are concerned, we use a DC to DC converters. So DC to DC converter, generally, if you are using a single switch, only one pulse we can generate. The pulse width and the frequency can be adjusted easily in the D space itself. So no need to use any additional microcontroller or Arduino. For open loop, you can use any devices. Closed loops are concerned, D space is better. Okay, so the switching pulses generator, this is an experimental result what we got it. So the such experimental result for comparison, the simulation pulses is also provided here. So same 60 degree pulses are, it will be coming under around one third of the pulse this that is given to the switches. The reason is here we are using a low voltage LED circuits. If you want to use a high voltage, such a cases, the pulse we can increase it. Okay, then the output voltage and the output current, we are getting around 60, the design value is 60, but we are getting 61.38. Then the design value is 300 milliamperes, but we got it as around 347 milliamperes ranges under rated condition of 230 volt. Okay, then the input voltage and the input current. So the input frequency is 50 hertz supply frequency, and the input current is coming under very, very minimum, and it is more or less a sinusoidal signal. So the power factor is better in this circuit. Then when you design any power electronic converter for LED driver applications are concerned, the rated voltage in Indian system is concerned to 30 volt. But when you see the literatures, are the research papers. The in US systems are concerned, the rated voltage is more or less coming under a 110 volt system is also there. So we have to test our LED from the minimum voltage to the maximum voltage ranges. So we have tested the voltage from a minimum of 110. That is, with respect to the others standard, we have tested what is the performance of the converters, because we have used an auto transformer. By using the auto transformer, the voltage is adjusted. So under 110 voltage is also the input voltage and the input current, and the output voltage and the output current is controllable. Now we are using a open loop condition. So according to the voltage variations, if you are using a same pulse width, then the output current and voltage will be variable. But suppose if you want to maintain a constant voltage and current, such a condition we have to adjust the pulses to get a maintain a same voltage of 60 volt and the current of some 300 or a 350 milliamperes. Then in between voltage also the circuit is tested. Finally, so now here we have tested with the three different input, rated voltage and 110 voltages and 150 voltages. But the variation in the input voltages causes a variation in the output voltage and the output current. But generally, whatever may be the fluctuation in the voltages, the LED has to maintain a constant current. That means the brightness should not vary. If there is a brightness variation, then that causes some fatigue to eyes or the So here, closed loop control is used with the help of some in LabVIEW platform. So we have a voltage sensor and the current sensor in LabVIEW devices. I think NI9227 and 9225. So current sensor and voltage sensors devices are used. We senses the using this sensor, the voltage and currents are sensed, and it is given as in one side we have used a PA voltage controller, and another side we have used a inner loop. We have used a PA current controller. So these two controllers are tuned in such a way that whatever may be the variation of the voltage is concerned, this gives a constant output voltage, the pulses. Okay, so this is again a LabVIEW sensor. So it gives an output voltage. Okay, so we have tested with only one type of that means the waveforms are given for a fixed pulse width as given in the simulation as well as in the hardware result. So we have obtained a output voltage of 60 volt and with a current of 300 milliamperes. Okay, so here we have discussed about the general introduction about what are the different lighting system available, and then what is an LED lamp, and then what are the characteristics of LED, how we have to represent the LED in terms of equivalent circuit, what are the general converter topologies available. Then we have discussed in detail about the PWM converter topology with some experimental result we have discussed. But using this converter, we have obtained an efficiency of around 98% under rated condition with input current ripple factor around some 14%, the input current. But generally for a lighting systems are concerned, there may be some standards are available, class A IEC standards are available. So we have to keep always the ripple factor of the current within the range when you use it for an LED lighting applications. Okay, so these are the different industry they are manufacturing LED flips that is available, Surya, Crompton, Panasonic, GE, Bajaj Electrical. So they are manufacturing different type of LED lamps. But LED standard manufacturers are available. Them that is a crew and some more manufacturers are available to manufacture the standard LEDs with some 3 volt to 350 milliamperes. Or some cases it is available some 700 milliamperes. So standard ratings are 350 milliamperes or 700 milliamperes. So when you use it, we have to maintain the power factor and THC as per the standard that gives the code as this, the IEC code IEC 610032. In that there may be different classes are there. In that class C gives the applications about the lighting equipment where the current harmonic should be below 28%. So then for our systems are concerned, government is also has taken different initiatives for LED lighting system. At present, they have replaced so many street lights by an LED street lights by the scheme Street Lighting National Program for LED. Then subsidized LED lamps are also available under the scheme, that is the Ujala scheme. Okay. So the present scenario is concerned, we are using most probably the LED lamps, and we are replacing the conventional lighting system by LED. Then institutions also, we have to replace most of the that is conventional lighting system by an LED lighting. When you go for any ranking or an accreditation systems are concerned, generally these things they are expecting. Are you using any renewable sources? Are you using energy efficient lighting or LED lighting? What is the saving of electricity? So such a detail generally they are asking for ranking and the accreditation. That is the major purposes. We have to replace the conventional lighting system by the energy efficient LED system. Then we can see in different automobiles also, that mean in cars and two wheelers also, present days we are using LED lighting system. So then what is the general demerits of an LED? Okay, so generally when you see that the lifetime of the driver circuit is minimum, the life of an LED is maximum around 50,000 hours. But when you see the lifetime of the converters, because we are using a power electronic switches, so the switches have to withstand the surges. If there is a failure of the switches, then when you see that there is no illumination, so finally we identify that the lamp that is lamp fails. But when you see actually there is a failure of the converters, so that was we have shown in the experimental result. That is, we have used different LED street lighting in our campus. So some of the lamps are concerned, only the converter failures occur. So we have taken that and we have checked the LED, but the LEDs are in proper working condition. Such LEDs we are using for our research purposes. Second thing is replacement of an electrolytic capacitor. So the electrolytic capacitor lifetime is also minimum. So instead of an electrolytic capacitor, if you use a film capacitor, then such a condition again we can increase the lifetime of an total LED driver. In addition to this, we are connecting the driver circuit or the LED bulb in a lamp holder or a tube light, we are connecting directly to our EB system. So such a conditions, we have to check the input power factor and the THG also, because it should not affect the quality of the power. Okay. So electrolytic capacitor we can replace with the film capacitor. Then the size of the electrolytic capacitor is also normally very big, but when you see the film capacitor, the size is generally minimum. When the size is reduced, automatically we can reduce the overall size of the converter. Okay. So the general conclusion for LED, that is the conventional lighting system, we can replace with an LED. Then we can use a different type of converter that is available or what we have studied already in the power electronic circuit we can use. You just test with a simple buck converter to just take a DC supply from a battery or an RPS, just design a buck converter and buy some small LEDs and connect it and check it. So such a way we can start our research. So here and cost effective PWM converter was developed and the results are also discussed. Then when you see the research area of an LED, we can develop a high efficient, high power factor with low input current THG. As per IEC standard, we can design different power electronic converters. So when you refer the IEEE transactions on power electronics or other high impact vector journals or an ACA indexed journals, we can see many that is power electronics converters for LED lighting applications. The present days when you see it, most of the time they are discussing with single stage converters, because when you are using a single stage, we can eliminate the number of components or the devices requirement, we can reduce the size of the converters, so the overall cost we can minimize it. Another thing is reducing the number of switches also. But in the PWM converter, we have used more number of switches, that is four switches are used, but the control wise the circuit is very, very simple. Okay, so we have published a few papers also in LED driver circuits. So recently we have published our paper in International Transaction on Electrical Energy Systems. The presented concept we have published. If you want to refer further, I think you can refer this paper. Or if you need this, I think if you contact, then I will send the paper all for your references. Actually, we have started the work with respect to some, initially we have started with some review. That is, we started with some passive LED driver circuit. We did some work, then we did some review. Then we started with some DC to DC, some PWM converters. Then we have used again some flyback converter. Then there we have used pulse density modulations. So one thing actually I missed, in some applications we have to control the brightness of the LED also. That is actually the dimmable LED lighting. So to control the brightness, we can go for, actually we have used as a pulse density modulation, or it is also called as a double pulse width modulation. There we can mix a high frequency signal and a low frequency signal in such a way that to control the overall brightness of an LED. But to control the brightness, most probably you have to maintain a maximum current and the average current to be controlled. So when you are mixing a high frequency and a low frequency, it is difficult to identify the flickering. Our human eye won't identify the difference in the flickering systems. So such a way we can use the brightness control, that actually coming under the dimmable LED lighting. Simple example, automobile systems are concerned, we will depends upon the focus, we will use to the brightness controls are there. So such applications we can use the dimmable LED lighting concept. See, for any further queries or a clarification, you can send mail or you can contact through the mobile number also. So I thank all the participants and the organizers for giving this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Rita.
On behalf of our management, I thank Dr. R. Gunabalan for sharing his valuable timing with us. And I thank all the participants for their patience. Once again, I thank all the participants and Dr. R. Gunabalan. Thank you very much.
Thank you, one and all.